Hey, what's up, YouTube? So, yes, it's Super Bowl Sunday here in the US, and I'm very disappointed and very sick to my stomach right now. So, I guess I have to rant a little. So, while my husband's enjoying himself and yucking it up with all his friends downstairs watching football, I'm left with this. Yes, this. This sort of like, it looks like a crime scene. And this is an 1890s French Fleischmann and Blondel doll that I just sold actually on the internet for $750. Yes, $750. And what happened, might you ask? My husband decided we had this little like attic little space here. It's like a little what I call a nook. And I kept a couple of my antique dolls in here. He decided to take all his heavy history books, which are like all hardcover, have like 500 pages in them, and stack them from the bottom all the way up to the top of this little nook. And he shoved them in. I mean, shoved them. And this beautiful doll was broken into a million pieces, as you can see here. So she had her original clothes and everything. I don't have it in this nook right now. I took it out because I'm just disgusted. And she had her original wig. I mean, she looked gorgeous. I mean, absolutely stunning. She doesn't look so stunning right now, as you can see here. See, he broke the head off. He broke the arms off from the body. And as you can see, the little arms are here. And this is not something I can easily fix. Generally, I can restring dolls, but this is a very difficult type of doll to restring. And so, genius over here decided to shove all his cheap Amazon.com books that he probably paid $1.99 for, and he shoved them in here. And now I just have to explain to this lady why I can't sell her this doll for $750 after she just was about to pay for it. I was just about to get payment. Now, $750 to some of you is not much. But to me, oh my God, it's like that was going to pay a lot of bills for me and my family. I have a college age daughter who's in school right now, and that money would have just paid for a lot of her classes and books. So it's all gone just because hubby decided to not listen to me when I told him, please don't put anything in this little nook because I have antiques in there. And he basically hates my antiques. And he said, oh, your stuff is crap. I don't give a crap. I'm just going to put whatever I want in there. And I said, please don't do that. Please. I really need my stuff to be where it's protected and it's not damaged in any way. And he's like, oh, your stuff is garbage. It's not worth anything. Well, honey, we just lost $750. A lot of you might think I'm a mean, vindictive wife right now, but I'm just pissed, honestly. While they're downstairs, he and all his friends are laughing and enjoying the goddamn Super Bowl. I'm stuck in this little area of my room, ready to cry. Yes. Burning red hot tears are about to fall down my cheeks because I just lost $750 that I was going to use to pay bills. And because my husband just didn't feel like putting his books on a bookshelf where they belong. So I'm going to end this rant to say that I'm just like, I don't know. I am just like so upset right now. And I just needed to get out all my anger. And I don't know if any of you antique collectors out there know what I mean by when something survives over 120 years, and just because some jackass decides to just toss their crap on it, it's gone. It's gone forever. And something that was in perfect condition and held on for all these years is now just like gone with the wind, just because of somebody's carelessness. Thanks for watching.